Wait, yeah. Mad for meat, Darren, you're mad for meat. Oh, zip up this thing, yeah. Oh, Darren, there you are. What just wrong with you?
Darren, how did you get to know Darren? I just started getting, he used to come in as a customer. And you'd see him looking around at me, so I said to myself, he asked a question, I thought he was interested, so I said, just give him a blast, get him out of away from the, bring him out away from, you know, get him thinking different. So we got him in an hour or two a week, and got him doing a little jack mince and beef, and cutting off meat with lava, and press the burger, pack and veg.
Darren, are you ready to work? What job would we do first, Jeremy? Here. Are we doing the straight veg first? Good man, leave them there at the top. Thanks, Darren. Baby cat. Baby cat. Ah, dear. Burger. Eat it. Butcher.
How long have I been a butcher, Darren? Jenny Mac, I've been a butcher over 30 years.
Years.
I've been a butcher over 30 years.
I like your job.
Do I like my job, Darren? I love my job, yeah. I like my job. Meeting the people and chatting and all right. Do you know what I mean? It's a lovely, lovely odd job. You like
meat, people, like the meat.
What meat do people buy, Darren? It varies. Depends on what sort of time of the year it is. If it's cold or warm, or steak or stew or meat or mince, you know what I mean? So it's just, it varies, whatever time of year. Cold or warm, or burgers or barbecue or for the winter, you know what I mean?
And it's famous.
No problem, Darren.
Do you know Darren, Rita? No. Yes, Rita, that's Darren.
Oh,
okay.
Thank you.
He helps
here sometimes.
All right, carry on. 179
Now, thank you.
Now, I used to enjoy him, which I do still, and it's good for him. And it's, do you know, he's a good old kid. It's great, how good, just give him a chance.
Meat.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm good.
Now, I'm the one that's here. The two of you coming in. Are you coming in, Linda?
Yeah.
How are you? I'm grand. Yourself?
All right.
Now, you going to do some work when you're here?
Brilliant.
How long do you work here? How long have I worked here? I'm here 11 years. Just 11 years in January. And I love my job. I love meeting all the people around here.
What do Twice Twice do?
What does the credit union do? Well, in the credit union, you can come in and save your money. And then when you get a bit older and has a job and things, you can come in and borrow little bits of money. So we can save money with the credit union, and you can borrow bits of money, small amounts of money. Maybe to buy a car or to fix up your bedroom or go on a holiday or something like that.
I go on my holiday. I go with Gary. I go on holiday with John Minner.
Do ya? Well, you can come in here and you can save your money every week, and you'll have money then to go on your holidays.
How are you getting home to St. Christopher's?
St. Christopher's? Oh, we're involved a long time in St. Christopher's. Yourselves, the service users, come down here. They all have their accounts here, and we knew you from coming in and out. So then somebody from St. Christopher's came in and asked us if he could do work placement here. So we got somebody each year, somebody came down and they helped us here once a week for a good few weeks. And we got to know you all then very well, didn't we, Linda? You came down yourself and did some work, and Kevin and Darren and all the users came down and did work with us, didn't you? We had a great time. Yeah, we had.
Well, Kevin, how are you doing?
I'm doing okay.
You're doing okay. Mm-hmm. Keep your eyes on your work now. Okay? Mm-hmm. Just straighten it up. Now, that's lovely. When you have it finished, you can just leave it there and do the next one. Mm-hmm. Now, good man. Okay?
Well, they worked with us in the back office and they came down once a week. So we left any shredding that was to be done, we left the shredding for them. They organised the any postage that was to be done that day. We left it and they put the stamps on all the envelopes and indeed did ones in advance. And what else did they do? Any punching when for the filing for coming on to the end of year, we left all the documents there and they punched them. So we had lots of organising and putting away of things when they had their work done when they were gone. But we enjoyed having them.
Have you a funny story, though?
Any funny stories? Well, we don't have often funny things in here, Linda. We don't. It's always in and out. But we had a pigeon one day, was trying to get in the door. The wind blew him in and he fell down and hurt his wing. So we had to bring him up to the vets. Edwina put him in the car and brought him up to the vets.
Why is that?
Because he hurt his wing. So we had to bring him up to the vet just up the road. Oh. And the vet kept him.
We were being robbed.
Robbed? Oh no, we'd never be robbed here. Oh, we're very careful with our money. We wouldn't let anyone rob us.
Thank you. Everyone.
Well, thank you, Linda. It was lovely to have you here. Okay, Linda. Thank you very much for coming down. It was lovely to have you. Okay? And we'll see you again. All right.
Hello, PJ. How are you today? I've got some
books to bring
back. Hello, how are you today, Cameron?
I'm grand, Joe. How are you?
How are you, yeah. How long have you been working here in this day?
I'm 12 years here.
Many books here?
There's about 34,000 books all together here in this library.
Is the work hard?
The work is very enjoyable. It is, can be hard now because we're a very busy library.
It's a beautiful library. Can you tell us a bit about the library?
This library was opened February 2011. It's a brand new project in 2011.
Yeah. Tell us about your volunteer program.
So I do get people in and we have let them help me in the library. So sometimes like there is a lot of work here, so I would not be able to do it all. So we get volunteers in so they can help me when I'm very busy.
Thanks very much.
All right, so.
So you enjoying this?
Yeah.
And have you done many interviews before?
No, this is my first time. My name is Jesse Farrell, and I'm here today to talk to Kelly about her job.
Hey, Jesse, how are you?
How long has the centre opened?
The centre has opened in 2002, this centre here, but the ISPCA has been active since 1949.
And do you like your job?
I do, yeah. It's a great old job when you work with animals and you see poor sick animals come in and you get them back on their feet again, and then, you know, the lovely day when they get their new home. So it's a great, rewarding job.
Do you see many cases of cruelty?
Yes, unfortunately we do. The ISPCA takes animals only from our inspectors. and inspectors go into people's homes and take animals that have been neglected and abused. Jessie is one of the dogs. She came from Cork. She was neglected by her owner. And when inspector found her, she was very, very underweight, and she had 12 pups on her as well. So she was rescued, and her pups all found a lovely new home, and she's looking for a home now for herself. So, you know, the cruelty calls is sad, you know, but when you see them thriving and then going to a new home, it's sort of happy.
It upsets you a bit, doesn't it?
It does, but you know well that you can get the animal back on their feet again. So that makes you happy again.
Do you have many volunteers?
Yes, we have a few volunteers. Yourselves are great for coming in every week without fail. And we have other groups that come in, and weekends would be our busiest time with volunteers. The families would come in with their kids. See, we've got other animals, we've got the rabbits, the horses and donkeys, and people like to come in with you know, pieces of carrot and apple and give us them, and walk the dogs and play with the cats. So it's a great place for a volunteer.
There's a poignant.
Jesse and his fellow volunteers come down to us. They wait for the staff member to come down, and we give them the dogs that are well suited to them, that won't be hauling them about or anything that's too nervous. Something that will enjoy the walk as well as them enjoying it as well. You know, basically it's just walking them down the roads, sometimes down the back fields, and you know, just spending time with the dog. That's the most important thing, you know, is that dog getting that one-on-one attention. And then, like I said, on very, very wet days, to be down in the cattery block, grooming the rabbits, the cats. And just playing with them inside. But the majority I know you've done is just, it's just the walking of the dogs. And it's a great help, because today I'm on kennels on my own, and I'm minding near 30 dogs. So, you know, we're always desperate for volunteers. I'm always happy to see people come in and help. It's just one less dog for me to walk, and it means that I can do extra care that's needed that I can't do.
I'd like to thank you for your time, and the best of luck.
Well, thank you very much. And you're very well appreciated.
Thank you.
Thank you. From the inspectors and cruelty.
And then the dog.
Darren,
you're a devil!
Take it.
So what type of meat do people buy? What meat do people buy?
Action.
Don't sell me, Jess.
Well, it's very hard.
Oh, yeah. We forgot we were in the trade.
Don't be looking at us, Kevin. Look at your work. Don't be looking at us.
it's really good, really good, really good. Now, Jesse, maybe walk around this side and get a close-up of PJ's face, the look of concentration on PJ's face as he goes about doing his job.
What a good place to be. Don't believe I speak a different language, and it's never really happened to me.